Welcome in. Welcome to the Old Salem Apothecary. We provide potions, spells, and tonics. We also provide psychic stuff, like crystal balls and private readings and tarot cards. And today we're having a... It's you! Come here. You don't recognize me? How long has it been? Oh, I see what happened. Yes. You went ahead and died, didn't you? You had to go ahead, you had to die and come back, and now you don't know who I am. Sounds about right. Well, I assume you're here for a reason, so go ahead, tell me what your problem is. No, wait. Let me guess. All I need is this. You. This. Okay, you just sit still. Boop, boop. You're gonna have to tell me what you need. Oh. Okay. So you don't know. You're just here for fun. You just heard about the witch in town and you wanted to see what was up.
That's really understandable,
to be honest. So, let's do everything. First, we need to cleanse the magical space. But to do that, I need to pull all the bad energy and go whew, and that makes it go away. You need to think
that it makes you have your energy just bounce around the room because we didn't make it leave. But
trust me, it's very, very magical and very, very effective. Okay, so let's do it. Boop. flick, pluck 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 flick,
energy card, bad energy card,
bad energy card, bad energy card. Bad energy gone. 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 Bad energy gone.
Bad energy gone.
Bad energy gone. Bad energy gone. Bad energy gone. Bad energy gone. Energy gone. Bad 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 energy gone. What's that? Bad energy gone. How are you feeling now? Yeah, most people don't feel any difference, but trust me, magic, it makes a difference. You want a sterile environment. So, really excited. So nice to see you after a few centuries. Wow, time sure has flown. You look good.
Yeah, you look really good. You look really, 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 really good.
Very cute. So, next. I think the next thing is to do a tarot reading. Or maybe I can do a crystal ball reading for you. Yeah. And then we can get a general sense of your vibes and your aura and a vague look into the future. And then
once we know exactly what we're looking for,
we can do tarot reading, to be more specific. Yeah, more specific. Okay, then
I can go ahead and start making a potion for you.
And then to end it off, I'll do a protection spell. Just in case. Okay? Okay. So, I think crystal ball. Thank you. This is very concerning. I think I'm going to need
to do a tarot card reading
to make sure we know what to do. Show you your past, present, and future. This is your past, the Eight of Swords. This card shows a history of negative thinking and self-limiting and self-destructive behavior. Shows a quite a lot since I last saw you. How many lives have you lived since I saw you? I'm sorry. Your present. The tower. The tower describes a sudden realization. It describes change, new knowledge. Something is going to happen very soon. And now you are learning more about what it is
so that you can prepare yourself.
So this is very good. Struggle past a lot of pain caused by other people and pain caused by yourself. It shows us struggle that you've gone through. See, she's full of swords. She lies in the snow. This indicates possibly depression, relations with others that have gone wrong, as I already described. This would mean nothing to you now. If it was in the future, then that's knowing that you will realize something. What could you do today? Nothing. So this is good. It means that we're learning something. Cassidus show doom and gloom, then soared straight into her back. But
we have a warning, which means that we can fight this enemy. Can you think of any enemies you might have?
Anyone who'd want to hurt you? Anyone who'd want to cause you harm? And that'll solve everything, don't you think? I think so. So don't take too much negativity from this reading, because we have a warning. The future is not set. We can do something about this. Okay. Okay. Very important that I wear this cloak. Oh no, it doesn't give me like magical boosts or anything. It's just really, really cute. Okay, well, the cards definitely have said what they wanted to say, so I think that it would be best if I got you a potion. Do you think that you'd be able to get this enemy to drink something that you'd give them? Good. I definitely think that you should go for that challenge, because this potion works best when used on the actual sense of danger. Okay? Okay. So now we're going to make the potion, and I know exactly ingredient number one. I have all these little artifacts that I've gathered during my time as not just a witch, but working in an apothecary. So this right here is actually the soul of a black cat, because we want your enemies to be very, very unlucky. And as much as black cats actually help witches against other people, they do actually bring bad luck. So this is the soul of a black cat. And don't worry, it wasn't harmed by me. I just found it, the soul, wandering around, and decided to put it into this physical form so that I could be able to use it for magic. But it wasn't selfish. It's happy in there, aren't you? You didn't hear the screaming, did you? Good. It was a joke. It smells very fruity. Yes. Fruity. Like citrus and flowers. Yes. It smells very good. Into the potion it goes, into my cauldron, right here. Boop. Ba-doop-ba-doop, into the soup-a-rooney. Next ingredient, I think. The next ingredient is ghost laughter. Ghosts laughing about their future death. see, that's what I was thinking. I was thinking that it was a great idea. So, oh, this one smells like...
I want to say lemons. Lemongrass, maybe. And... cocoa butter. Oh, this smells so good. Smell. Right.
Ghost laughter. It's weirdly... fragrant. Into the potion. And the next ingredient is dried jack-o'-lantern fruit. And
this is actually a really rare piece of
fruit. I actually invented them myself, and I grow them in my yard. So instead of having to grow pumpkins and then carve them and do all that stuff, they just grow by themselves. And this one's dried up, so I can use it
in potions really easily. So
I figure since jack-o'-lanterns were created to ward off ghosts and spirits, it will get rid of your enemy. It'll make them scared to go near you. That was the thought. It smells like cinnamon and lime and pumpkin, of course. A bit of pumpkin. So, yeah. Smell it. It's good, right? This potion is gonna smell so good. Into the potion. It's just the sound that I like to make when I'm brewing potions. Liquid ingredients. So the next ingredient that I have is this jar. Boop. And it has the ectoplasm from Poltergeist. And it's...
actually, it smells really good.
It's weird. But Poltergeists, they like haunt and mess with people and break stuff. So I figured we probably would want your enemy to be scared and horrified. Keep it in this little jar. Here it is. Boop, 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 boop. Boop, boop, boop. It's coal. Gross. Boop, 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 boop. Boop, 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 boop. Boop, 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 boop. Smells sort of like bubblegum. Yeah.
It smells exactly like bubblegum.
Bloop, bloop, bloop. Into the potion. Bloop, 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 bloop. Into the potion. In to the potion. Into the potion. Bloop, 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 bloop. Okay, now. Into the cold. There we go. Get some from the jar. Drop it into the potion. Some from the jar. Drop it into the potion. Some from the jar. And into the potion. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Gross. So now, the next potion item that we have is magic crystals. This is the goop that goes inside crystal balls that makes it go and let you see things. So I figure we'll torment your enemy with horrible visions of their future failures. Every night before bed, imaginary situations that hasn't even happened, failures that are yet to come to pass. I know it's sort of evil, but we're in the business of curses too. It's full of little crystals and purple goop. Like this. Blah, blah, blah. Gross. Bloop, 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 bloop. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Bloop, bloop, bloop. So we're gonna get a nice little handful out of the jar, put it straight into the potion. Ugh, gross. It's all over my hands. Smells like mint. That's what it smells like. It smells exactly like mint. Get the excess off and put it back in the jar. We don't need that much for this. People tend to have anxiety on their own and come up with all their own failures without our need for magical assistance. So, yeah. Ingredient is something called Essence of Twilight, and it's basically to encourage extra fear of the dark. Yeah, if you put it into a positive potion, it would give you like night vision. But in this case, since this is a pretty nasty potion to give to someone, it's more of gonna make them have that thing where they keep seeing horrible things out of the corner of their eye, and when they look, it's not there anymore. And they'll try to, you know, calm themselves down with this idea that the sides, like your peripheral vision, is stronger in the dark. But actually, it's demons. So, yeah. We're gonna give them nightmares. This bluish purple thick jelly like goop looks like this. We're just gonna take the whole thing, and we're gonna put it straight into the potion. This is what nighttime looks like. Gloop, 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 gloop. It's even a little glittery. So, into the potion. Bloop. So the next ingredient is something that I made myself. I call it an orb of relaxation. But in all honesty, it's pretty much just a bath bomb. And it's called... But it's called an orb of relaxation. And it's in Mercury in retrograde, something like that. And it smells like ginger and lemon. Yeah, but mostly I like adding it to this, not because it'll be relaxing for them, but it makes the potion go yeah. So, whoop. Now we're gonna stir all those ingredients. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Bloop, 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 bloop. Bloop, 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 bloop. Making horrible curses to screw over our enemies. That's what we do at the Old Salem Apothecary. Two more ingredients. This one is spider cider, and it's cider that I made from spiders. It's, I
actually pretty self-explanatory, but it tastes really horrible.
It's gonna make this potion taste really bad, so that it is really unpleasant to drink for them. So you're gonna have to be real careful that they drink the whole thing, because it's gonna taste really I do like drinking it sometimes when I'm alone. I get so lonely. And I have one more ingredient, which is ghost tears.
And ghost tears, like, are the opposite of ghost laughter.
Instead of just all of the things that, like, find funny, which is mostly death things. Ghost tears are all the things they're sad about, and it's gonna make them sad all the time. So, yeah, it's pretty self-explanatory. It tastes sort of like vanilla and raw eggs into the potion. So now we're going to stir it all up. I've got this fire going that's been cooking it up and boiling it. I've done that. And tries to fight you, then this will protect you. Okay, so I'm gonna be saying some magic words, and you're not gonna understand them, but that's okay, because you don't really need to understand everything for it to work. Okay. Do ba da do da do.
Rina na bushkaru.
Wush tama.
Je t'en joue bon, c'est toi. Je sais qu'on t'aille, tu j'étais rouge. soul should go.